Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Good morning. Today we celebrate the 16th Sunday in Ordinary Time. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so by following your holy will, we may gain eternal salvation. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the second form of the Confiteor found on page 66. I confess to Almighty God, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say to our fathers, may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Two things I ask of you, deny them not to me before I die. And lying far from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Provide me only with the food I need. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer, for you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, your Son had taught us to come to your daily bread. Have compassion on those who have been reduced to poverty and hunger. By your grace, let us cheerfully bear each other's burdens according to your will. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading is from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Woe to the shepherds who mislead and scatter the flock of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, against the shepherds who shepherd my people, you have scattered my sheep and driven them away. You have not cared for them. But I will take care to punish your evil deeds. I myself will gather the remnant of my flock from all the lands to which I have driven them and bring them back to their meadow. There they shall increase and multiply. I will appoint shepherds for them who will shepherd them so they need no longer fear and tremble, and none shall be missing, says the Lord. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David. As king, he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days, Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they give him, the Lord our justice. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The second reading is from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, in Christ Jesus you were once far off, have become near by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, he who made both one and broke down the dividing wall of enmity, through his flesh, abolishing the law with its commandments and legal claims, that he might create in himself one new person in the place of two, thus establishing peace, and might reconcile both with God in one body through the cross, putting that enmity to death by it. He came and preached peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him, we both have access in one spirit to the Father. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. My sheep hear my voice, says the Lord. I know them and they follow me.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. The apostles gathered together with Jesus and reported all they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away by yourselves to a deserted place and rest a while." People were coming and going in great numbers, and they had no opportunity even to eat. So they went off in the boat by themselves to a deserted place. People saw them leaving, and many came to know about it. They hastened there on foot from all the towns and arrived at the place before them. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. This is the gospel of the Lord.
His heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. So they're taken from today's gospel according to St. Mark, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, in our first reading from Jeremiah and our gospel from Mark, we hear about the whole shepherd and sheep metaphor, which is pretty prevalent throughout Scripture. Kind of apt in a way, because sheep always need someone to protect them and guide them. And in the case of Jesus in the gospel, he recognizes that those who are supposed to be shepherding the people kind of abandoned them. And here we have the situation where the 12 were sent out two by two, and they had just returned from their ministry, going out and healing people and teaching the kingdom of God that it was near. And they were hungry and tired, and he wanted to give them a rest. So they got on the boat, and a crowd gathered and saw that they were going and hightailed it all around the Sea of Galilee to where they were going, and got there before even they did. And Jesus says he was moved with pity for them, not because, you know, he felt sorry for their plight, but because they were lost. They were lost, and they needed someone to guide them to the truth of his Father. Now, in Jeremiah, we have a different situation. The shepherds of that time, now, we got to remember the historical context for what Jeremiah was in was right before the Babylonian exile. They were under the control of the Babylonian Empire, and a lot of the leaders, the religious leaders too, were under the influence of the pagan Babylonians. And they were worshiping idols like Baal and things like that. And so they were leading the people astray. So they were not just absent from their duties, but they were effectively leading the people wrong. Kind of like if you have a shepherd who's leading the sheep, not to safety, but straight to the wolves. That's exactly what they were doing in Jeremiah's time, right before the exile. And that also has to be addressed by God. And what he does is take them over himself until he can exile them, take them out, reset things, and then bring them back 40 years later. So what does all that mean for us? Well, firstly, we have to ensure that who we follow conforms to what has always and everywhere been taught in the deposit of faith, what has been handed down unadulterated for 2,000 years. If it deviates from that, we need to avoid it. If it conforms to that, we need to run towards it. But also, we need to become ourselves shepherds in a way to those around us, because we have been given that deposit of faith. And no matter where we are in our own faith journey, our own knowledge journey of what the church teaches, we do have at least some that we can go to those around us and help lead them to the Father and the Son, the truth. We're called to do that by our baptism and by the gifts we have been given from God. So as we go forward from here today, maybe sometime during the week, we can take some time and think about the ways, firstly, in which we can solidify our own knowledge and faith praying a little bit more maybe, getting closer to God. And secondly, look to those around us and help lead them. They may not follow, and that's okay, but at least give them the opportunity to come back to the truth that is in the person of Jesus, who always points us towards his Father. His heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Trusting that God hears and answers our prayers, let us join in offering our petitions to the Lord. And our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
For Prime Bishop Anthony, Father Senior Charles, and all pastors, that they may lead in faith and serve in love the flock entrusted to their care, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to war, violence, and hatred, that God's peace and compassion may fill every corner of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safe travels of all who are on vacation from our parish, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have strayed from the practice of the faith, that the Holy Scripture may grant in them a new desire for Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and their caregivers, especially those on our parish prayer list, that they may find strength and endurance in the healing love of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions we hold deep in the silence of our hearts, and for whom this Mass is offered, for the first anniversary of the passing of Patricia Kramer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, especially Helmut Erdmann, who will be buried on Monday, and those who will die today, that they may dwell in the Lord's house forever, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God our Father, Shepherd of souls, guide us on your path of peace. Hear our prayers, both spoken and unspoken, and in your mercy grant what we need. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
I, the Lord, am your God, who led you forth from the land of Egypt. Open wide your mouth, and I will fill it. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, through your Son's bread to offer to earth, as given human hands have made, may it become for us the bread of life. The mystery of this wine. And water, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, through your goodness, spread wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless the sacrifice we prepare for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and our blessed Virgin Mary, and all the saints, may they whose memory we honor on earth intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Almighty God, may we who offer this oblation be filled with the love of Jesus and go forth as instruments of your purpose. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through his teaching and ministry, Jesus showed us how we are to live, giving our lives in service to you and all people. Still hearing his word in our world today, we strive to follow his example and set our hearts on the world to come. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy Sacrifice of the Mass continues with Eucharistic Prayer 5, which is found on page 92. Blessed are you, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercy and God of all consolation. For you so loved the world that you gave your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He then established a lasting memorial of your salvation. On the evening in which he willingly surrendered himself, he took bread, gave you thanks, blessed it, and broke it, saying, Take it, this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which is given for you. When supper had ended, he took the cup. In the same way, he gave you thanks and blessed it, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me. So we recall before you, Father, the incarnation of your Son, his words and deeds, how he humbled himself and obediently accepted death, even death on the cross. Therefore you have raised him up and given him a name which is above every name, so that in heaven and under the earth every knee shall bow and every tongue proclaim to the glory of God the Father, Jesus Christ is Lord. We offer the sacrifice of your Son before you, Father, with praise and thanksgiving, and ask that you accept this oblation. Send your Holy Spirit and fill these gifts with his life-giving power, that they may be, for us, the body and blood of your dearly beloved Son. Grant that the bread which we break may be the body of our Lord, and the cup over which we give thanks may be one with the blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. The company of Mary, the Mother of God, with your apostles and martyrs, Holy Willibrord and all the saints, together with Anthony, our prime bishop, Charles, our administrator, and with all bishops, priests, and deacons, as well as your whole church, we praise and glorify you and look forward to the coming of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Let us now pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
Because there is one bread. We who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Let us say together the Second Communion prayer found on page 98. May the partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cause for my judgment or condemnation. Though I am unworthy to receive this great sacrament, through your loving kindness, may it become a guard and healing remedy. My saving master, awaken in me a living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and a holy longing. Through this communion, make me your willing servant, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it at last unite me entirely with you, my Lord and my God. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. For those who are joining us online and who for personal reasons cannot receive the body and blood of Christ today, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things. And I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. body and blood of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Blessed are you who are now hungry, for you will be satisfied. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, inspire us with your love and pity to bring to you every straying and famished soul. Be their shepherd, satisfy them with the living bread, and grant us the witness of your Spirit in our hearts. For you live and with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace, especially today with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for our Holy Mass today. And as I mentioned in the bulletin, if you would take a bulletin home with you on page 8, just once a day, say the prayers of St. Michael and St. Francis for peace and concord in our world that we need so much right now. Hope you have a wonderful day, wonderful rest of your weekend. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other. Remain in a state of grace. Fight evil wherever you find it. Spread joy and the word of God wherever you go.